Hello. My name is Stephen Weir, and this is incredible because I do PR, and I never get to do this. I am always in the back. I live about four blocks from the restaurant, and I'm the last person here. Thank you for coming. The event that we're going to talk about today is something that's really past due. We should have been doing this a long time ago. Today, though, we're going to write that. We have two people that are speaking. Well, we have a few people, but two principal speakers. Rose is the driving force behind this conference, and Chris and I worked together on the carnival, and so we're bringing some of the organizational not skills, but wherewithal to this event. Thank you for coming, and there'll be lots of opportunity to talk to our guests. So, Rose?
Okay, so my name is Rose Cathy Handy, and thank you again for coming. And this is really a great opportunity for us, and this event is it has been almost, what, a few years in the making. It's always great to see a little dream start becoming reality, and then bit by bit, and maybe it will grow. I will speak in French. I will also speak in English, because that's the beauty of Canada, of being bilingual. What I can tell you about this event is that, let me start from the beginning. I came in Canada in 1994, the beginning of 1994, but precisely in December 1993. And soon after, everything was going well. I was a producer for Rogers, the city council, so I was witnessing a lot of conversation going on. I also was hosting and producing a show at CHOY. I see some of the CHOY people here. And soon after 1994, the recession hit, and I'm sure all of you remember the recession back then. It was pretty hard, 94, 95. And for some reason, the black woman became the face of the recession, or the face of what can be wrong with the economy. They were being ridiculed, they were being mocked, and everybody was talking about how they're young, 19, with two children. Sometimes they're not even 25, they have three children, and they have to rely on welfare or on social assistance. I was here, I wasn't that black woman, but I was almost that black woman. And throughout the years, I've been observing the conversation, observing the narrative that has been going on, and looking at how we've come such a long way to get to where we are today in 2015. So I started thinking 2 years ago that if we fast forward 15 years, 20 years later, did anybody ever check what have happened to these women that were 19, 20, 21? Who were maybe relying on social assistance, who had two children, three children, and they didn't have jobs, they didn't have any support or anything. We see them out there, we live with them, and sometimes we are them. But do everybody else notice? And that's really what compelled me to push forward this event. That wouldn't it be great to have a platform where one day we really can bring the focus on this woman. Not only we can showcase them, we can honor them, we can celebrate them, but we can also inspire the other generation, because since we're here, we don't have a media. There's not black media like you find them in other places or other countries, like a black TV station. And so everybody is fighting for a little space that is on TV or radio to have your story up there, to have your achievement up there, to have your accomplishment up there. Yes, we see those that are in the media, we see those that are in politics, but what about all those that are in between? Who find them? Who tell people about them? Who tell the other generation about them? Who tell the newcomers about them? Because somebody who just got here, how would you know that you can make it in Canada? And I always draw to my personal story. When I came to Canada 2 years, I was coming from France. I'm from Cameroon. And 2 months after I got here, I went to a function that was out there, and then I went into the room, and who was there? The main guest was Jean Augustine. And at one point, I walk up to her, and I say hello, but that's all I could say in English. I couldn't speak English, and she couldn't speak French. But it was just amazing how we're able to exchange, we're able to talk. It did allow me to see that this is this woman that is here. If she has been able to do this, so actually it's possible in Canada. And that can make a huge difference in the life of a new immigrant. A woman where you come, you're French speaking or you're from Africa, and then you get here, you don't know if you made a right choice. You don't know if you can really make it. You don't know if other people can make it. And so it's important to see other models. It's important to see people who have done it. It's important to see other women like you who have done, who look like you, who maybe came from where you came from, who have maybe have the same background or the same story like you, who made it, and it gives that that encouragement, that inspiration. That also the idea of putting together this event so that we can have that platform where not only we can honor those that have already achieved a lot and we can really thank them, but at the same time, we can also put out there all this accomplishment and all these women that are doing great and bring the younger generation, bring the newcomers, bring everybody, and also bring the entire Canada to maybe change that little narrative and change that story where we never know. I mean, we wish there will never be another recession here, but we don't want the story to be about us again when there is the next recession, that black women, they're here and they're relying on social and assistance, because you also have a lot of black women here who own company, who employ people, who create jobs, who create who really help the economy, and who are impacting lives, society, and Canada, and also other generation. And so the event is on the 23rd, like you know, of May, and we're going to have all of those components and that event. It's very important for us to honor Jean Augustine, of course, because at this stage in 2015, she surprised us by announcing her retirement from public office. And it was just a nice timing that when she made her announcement, it was just at the time where we are putting together this event. And she has become really our icon. And it's really just fitting that if we have an event and we have a platform celebrating black women, we need to really honor this this great lady who has done so much, because she really embodies what it is coming from nothing and going all the way to the top in Canada. She was the first black woman to be elected in the parliament, and she was the first black woman to be in a federal government. And it's important for us to see that because she has done it, it's possible for other women to do it. And we will have a lot of those women who are running in the next election. And we really have a great selection of the women who are running. We have Selena, who is running for the Liberal Party. And we have Toyin Dada, who is running for the Conservative Party, and will be at the event. And it's really important to see that inspiration, and also that the chain is not broken and the chain is continuing. And really, that's the spirit that we want to bring at the event. Of course, to talk about the women, everything in between the media and the politics, you have everything else, which is education, which is life, which is employment, which is businesses, show business. For the longest time, show business has been maybe the easy sector, but it's not that easy, because a lot of these women, they have to hustle, they have to scrap, they need to fight, but they're making it. We have big movie producers, and we have one sitting right at the back, and and she will be in one of the 100 black women that will be showcased, and she has produced an amazing movie this year, and we have few others that are producing documentaries, movie, and publishers of magazines and newspaper, and so we'll showcase about 28 to 29 accomplished black women that are doing a lot of things here, and like as I mentioned, impacting generation, impacting corporation, and bringing the change that we need in our community, in our young girls, and also families. We've had the 100. Why we did the 100 Black Women? Because beyond celebrating, just celebrating and honoring, it was really important that every single year we bring this little story. Like I said, there is the media, there is the politics, there are those who have access. But you also have a whole great number of women who don't have access, but who do so many amazing things. And the stories, when they will come out, they will be really very moving. And I was so impressed going through the profile with the how they made it, and how really you find a woman who... maybe she decided to create a program in her neighborhood where she was helping other children learn piano lesson, because otherwise they wouldn't have had an opportunity to learn piano. You'll find women who are championing issue for Black people with disabilities. Sometimes that's not a story that you hear out there. That's already so hard to hear about people with disabilities, but then to find somebody like a Black woman focusing on the Black people with disability is really amazing. And it's those kind of stories that we really want to bring out there and give that day where there is that focus, and we can bring everybody to notice that they're here, notice that they're doing all this, notice that whatever they're doing is bringing a lot of impact, because we're contributing a lot in Canada, and we're also helping our sisters, and we're helping our family. There is a personal inspiration too to this event. It's about my personal story with this. I traveled back in Cameroon in 2010, but I wish it was for a great celebration. But it wasn't really for a great celebration. When I traveled there, because I lost my younger sister. But the amazing thing that happened at that funeral is that she was 38, but 600 people show up at the funeral. And when I was standing there, I saw 600 people. I was thinking that maybe because of my mom, because she has been involved in a lot of women organization, maybe because of my dad, who was a teacher for very long, but teachers usually don't move 600 people for the funerals. And then one by one, I started hearing about my little sister, how she touched lives, how she changed people's life. And I realized that I don't even know my own sister. I didn't even know my own sister. I didn't know what she has accomplished, what she has done. And maybe I could have done more for her, or maybe I could have done something, even if I'm far away from a distance, because when we talk about the sisterhood of a Black woman, it's not just the one that I hear in Toronto, it's not just the one that are in Canada, we all link together. And that's really the idea of making this platform international, Canada International Black Women Event, so that it's also a reminder to all of us that while I'm here, I have many links. Somebody asked me earlier where I'm from. When I said, yes, I'm from Cameroon, but I spent 7 years in Europe. By spending 7 years in Europe, I left a lot of links, and it's really important to always honor that link, because today we're talking about globalization, we're talking about not being alone with social media and all that, and so it's important really to open that platform and to always make it a reminder of all the links that we have and that we depend on each other here. As I mentioned, we have a few women that are here that are assembled. Some of them, they texted me that they're on the way. But I would like to introduce... okay. Merci beaucoup. Donc, comme je disais, cet événement, c'est vraiment un événement spécial, et c'est un événement qui a germé un petit peu dans ma tête et qui a été inspiré par des événements parfois personnels, mais c'est aussi des événements qui ont influencé un peu ma vie. Je suis arrivée au Canada en décembre 93, et en 94, j'avais eu le privilège de travailler comme réalisatrice pour Rogers, qui était en train de filmer le conseil municipal de Toronto. Effectivement, étant réalisatrice à Rogers, ça m'a permis d'écouter énormément de conversations, énormément de débats. Et j'animais aussi une émission à la radio CHY que je produisais aussi moi-même. Mais pendant ce temps-là, en 1994, ce qui s'est passé en Ontario, dont on se souvient tous, c'est qu'il y a eu la récession. Et malheureusement, avec cette récession, et je dirais curieusement, c'est le visage de la femme noire qui était dans tous les débats, dans tous les exemples. Et on s'en moquait, on en parlait. Elle était devenue pratiquement comme une des raisons pour laquelle l'économie va mal. On parlait de celles qui ont 19 ans avec deux enfants et qui doivent dépendre du bien-être social, ou celles qui ont moins de 25 ans et trois enfants qui ne travaillent pas. Donc, tout au long des années, j'ai continué à suivre un petit peu cette conversation-là et de voir qu'est-ce qui se passe. Mais ce qui est toujours resté dans ma tête, c'est de me demander si, après 15 ans ou 20 ans, est-ce que quelqu'un s'est soucié de voir que sont devenues ces femmes? Parce que c'est sûr que après 15 ou 20 ans, la vie de quelqu'un, quoi qu'il arrive, va changer. Mais est-ce qu'on s'est soucié de voir que sont devenues ces femmes? Nous, en tant que femmes noires, on les voit, on vit avec elles, on les rencontre. Parfois aussi, elles sont nous, nous-mêmes. Et puis, on voit tout ce que ces femmes sont capables de réaliser. Plusieurs sont en politique, plusieurs sont dans les médias, plusieurs sont à la tête des corporations et plusieurs sont des entrepreneurs. Et c'est vraiment la raison pour laquelle c'était important de faire cet événement et d'avoir une plateforme qui peut permettre qu'on décide en un jour, on peut peut-être ramener la concentration sur les femmes noires, de pouvoir sortir un peu ces histoires qui sont cachées ici et là, et de vraiment les mettre au grand jour, de pouvoir attirer l'attention sur les réalisations, parce que c'est souvent très facile de parler des difficultés ou des problèmes, mais d'amener aussi l'attention sur les réalisations que ces femmes-ci ont. Et c'est pour cela vraiment qu'il y a cette journée-là. Et effectivement, on connaît les femmes noires qui sont dans les médias en politique parce que celles-là, elles ont accès. Et comme ici au Canada, on n'a pas vraiment une chaîne de télévision pour les noirs. Et c'est toujours très difficile d'aller sortir les histoires de celles qui sont au milieu parce que les deux extrêmes, les médias à gauche et puis la politique à droite, c'est très facile d'avoir un regard sur ces femmes. Mais qu'est-ce qui se passe avec toutes celles qui sont au milieu? Je parle de celles qui sont dans les soins de santé, celles qui sont en train qui sont dans le service public, celles qui travaillent, celles qui créent des entreprises, celles qui emploient, qui créent aussi de l'emploi et celles qui vraiment apportent les changements, que ce soit dans les sociétés, dans les familles ou dans nos environnements. Et c'est pour cela que c'est très important de vraiment amener toutes ces histoires, de pouvoir avoir une journée où on peut ramener vraiment cette concentration, regard sur ces femmes-là. Donc, effectivement, c'est très important ce jour-là qu'on honore celles qui ont été les premières, les pionnières, on a appelé. Et on n'a pas meilleure pionnière que Jean Augustine. Et qui va être honorée ce jour-là parce qu'elle nous a surpris récemment, au mois de mars, en annonçant sa retraite de la vie publique. Et comme ça tombait bien que c'est à ce moment-là qu'on a un événement, c'était très important vraiment de l'honorer ce jour-là. Et on va aussi avoir des présentations de plusieurs femmes. Et ça va être très intéressant de vraiment venir célébrer ces femmes et de pouvoir mettre ces histoires en avant. So as I was saying, in the room we have really a little sample of the women, the caliber of women that we will be showcasing on the 23rd. And I'm not putting you guys on spot. Merci, agenda. Some of them are running a little bit late, but because we're also running late, and I usually like to do things on time. And so I'm just going to call you guys here to come up here. And we have Solange Belluz, who is the executive in residence at Glendon, and she's doing a tremendous, tremendous work at Glendon in education and post-secondary education in Ontario in Canada in general. I will call Shelley Jarrett, who is here. She's a publisher of a magazine. Do you mind? Yes. It's not to put you on the spot, but and we have a Tiffany Ford, who's a school trustee. They are a little bit a sample of the panelists that we're going to have, and also the women that we will be really showcasing in the 100 Black Women to Watch in Canada, because they're doing things now, but it's just the beginning, I can tell you. If you ask every one of them, they're going to tell you it's just the beginning. They have a lot of things. They're asking to. That's my. And I would like to add into this, because we had the chance to have them, so you're just in, so you have to just come. Cheryl Nimbarden, she's a movie producer, and she owns a production company and also owns a theater. So as you can see, she doesn't just produce movie, but now she's trying to pass on the knowledge to other generations. It's okay. We also have the chance to have within the 100 women, I will call her. I know she didn't plan on that happening. We have Stacey Ann Buchanan in the room here. She will be showcasing a 100 Black Women to what you will come up. And we have Diane Ojar Ali. I think she has in a plan to revolutionize what is web TV and community TV, to change the face of that. Yeah. Okay, perfect timing, Michelle. You can just come up, Michelle Smith. She is our great advocate nurse, and a health advocate, and she's an oncology nurse. And she goes everywhere because her goal is to make sure that every Black person have access to health care in Canada. So this gives you a great sample, but really a little sample of what we're talking about. And what will be happening on the 23rd. So you see the caliber. And as I mentioned, is really these stories, and if you go behind every single story and measure the impact in our community, in the society, in Canada here, and beyond Canada, it's really great to see that as Black women, we're doing this. And it's really important for it to be noticed and for it to be shared, and also to help our younger generation, our daughters, to see that it can be done. And I know that I was regretting, because I have my little one who wanted to come today, and I should have brought her. That is really important for them to see it, because sometimes they hesitate, and sometimes they have story at school where they tell them that, okay, no, don't worry. You can maybe just try to be a secretary, or just try to be this little thing, and try to be this little that. There's nothing wrong with being a secretary. But if they have that ambition, and I know, like I said, what it did for me to come to Canada 2 months later and meet face-to-face with Jean Augustine, it did something that stayed with me. That's why I'm talking about it 21 years later. It made me believe that it's possible to go to the highest level here in Canada. And really, it's important for me to see that the younger generation have the same experience, and whatever dream they have inside, it's something that they can live it, and they can believe it, and they can make it real. And they will be available. All of them will be available. If you guys have questions, you will need to talk to them. They will be available after. I usually tend to talk too much. I really tend to talk too much, but they will be available. And of course, we invite all of you to come on the 23rd, and so that you can meet them and all the other 30 and something that will be there, and the 100 that we will showcase, because we will really be in that sequence. We will showcase 6 in the morning, 30 during the day, and full 100 at the evening gala. And we expect all of you to be there, and to bring all your team, and so that we can really celebrate, and they deserve it. And that's really, all these women that I'm blown away, really, when I was going through each profile, it's like, I can't believe. But because there's one thing for me to think of the idea, sitting at my at home on. But when you actually read and you actually see what they have accomplished, I'm sitting there saying, but I can't believe this. And it really has to be out there. And we have to celebrate it. And we need to do this every single year. And I thank you, ladies. yes. But like I said, it will be available. And if you have a question, we have this media that are here that came. There are two that were supposed to be here. I believe CTB Global and Radio Canada. But they text something, so they cannot be here. But Radio Canada, they will arrange. They want to arrange interviews. And so they will be contacting some of you throughout the time until the event. And I hope you guys will make yourself available so that you can talk to them. You can talk to them, and so we can keep putting you out there. And thank you. Well, putting together this event, I had to go get some help because sometimes I think I can honestly tell you that I was scared. I was scared. I had a great idea, and I keep saying that openly, that the idea has been sitting on my desk for 3 years. But I was scared, honestly, because every time I said, okay, I don't have a big women organization behind me. I'm more involved in the business, in the business world. And so how do I go about putting this together? And one day somebody showed up at my office and I was talking about it again. And then he said, but this is the third time I hear you talking about it. You need to get get on with it and then do it. I said, but where do I start? And then he said, okay, there's somebody that I can introduce you to and then talk to him and then see. And before I knew it, I'm talking to the person who put together, who's involved in making the carnival, the Scotiabank Carnival happen. And I said, oh my God. Yeah, so I was introduced to Chris Alexander, and then he came to my office and when I present the idea, and he said, do it, I'll be behind you 100%. You have to do this, do it. And I said, well, but if I have to do it, you have to come with me. You have to come with me and do this with me. And then he graciously accepted. He has been very generous with his time and resources. And so I would like to introduce Chris Alexander. Yeah. And so who's going to talk some more?
Okay, just say a few words. Well, thank you so much for being here today. I just stand in the corner here. No, oh. Yeah. No, it's great to have these women here because I don't want to stand in front of you. So it's great to have that. You know, I grew up around women, obviously. My mother's a strong woman. I have two sisters ahead of me and one after me. So as a little kid growing up, I played only girl games and Chinese kips. I don't know if you know morale, and I grew up in the Caribbean, obviously, so I played everything until my dad said one day, you got to get outside. He bought me goats. And that's the reason why I decided to get outside and play a lot with boys. But saying that, this is an amazing event, and it's great that we have the opportunity right now to showcase our women. And not women doing it, but men should be doing it also. So I'm proud to be part of this, us taking care of our women, and showcasing them and making sure that they're out there and people know exactly what they are, what they do. They're very strong in terms of what they go through on a day-to-day basis. They go up against a lot of odds and they make it. And the reason why we are proud to support that and to make sure that this event becomes what it is because of these women, the reason for that. I want to tell you a little bit about what's going to happen on that day. So I'll just touch base on the event itself. It will take place at the Hilton, Toronto Hilton Hotel, and it's going to be at Richmond and University Avenue. So we'll be utilizing that hotel to have the event. Now, the event itself will take place in three parts. We'll have the breakfast, which will be a pioneer breakfast. Will take place between 7:45 and 9:30 in the morning. And in that, Rose talked about honoring Jean Augustine because she retired. So we'll be having pioneers, but also honoring Jean Augustine for what she's done over the years. And it's a great time to showcase this woman and given her the opportunity to speak to us and have young people being there to see exactly what's going on. So that's the first part of the event. Throughout the day, we'll have panel discussions, and there are discussions on a number of different areas. Make it in politics, make it in media, in business, in show business, in the workforce, in life. There's a number of areas that women will be there showcasing themselves, telling you exactly what's going to be going on and how they made it in life and how they made it throughout all the different careers that they've had. So we will do that also. And we'll have a marketplace, obviously. The marketplace will be there. We have Industry Canada as part of it. We have a number of women who has businesses that will be showcasing their businesses, and they'll be in there showcasing what they have, what they do, the type of businesses that they have. So we'll be doing that also. The booths are available, so we'll have booths for $200 and $500. Those are the booths that we will have throughout the day. Then, part of the event will be fundraising. Some fundraising will take place. Rose talked a little bit about her sister in Cameroon. She didn't say everything about her sister, some of the things that she's done, but she was 38 years old when she died. And she spent her life as a nurse literally helping women with HIV because everybody stayed away from them. So obviously she helped them deliver their babies, send the kids to school, take her own money and do the stuff. So when she said about 600 people were there at the funeral, they weren't there just for the sake of being there. She was there helping them throughout when nobody else would do that. So that's the piece that we want to fundraise for, that to send children to school, between 30 to 50 kids, get them to go to school and to continue that legacy in terms of what she's been doing and to help these kids as they go forward. So that's part of what we'll be doing for the fundraising for her. Now, the tickets will be different. You can get tickets for the breakfast, which will be $50. You can get tickets for the panel discussion throughout the day, will be $20, and then the gala will be $95. The gala is an amazing event, and the gala will take place from 7 to 11, and we will showcase 100 black women. We'll also showcase the panelists that we have in throughout the day, and the keynote speaker is Tracy Joshua. Is that her name? She's vice president of Kellogg's, and both Canada and the U.S., and she'll be coming also to participate in the event. So we're looking forward to her to make sure that she can give us a good keynote speech. She's made it also, and she's done a lot of great things, and we want to make sure that we continue to showcase our women. So you can get the tickets online through the website, which is cibwe.ca. And you can contact myself, you can contact Rose to get tickets. And we want you to come out, have a great time. It's going to be an amazing event, the first of its kind, and we want you to be there. It's going to be great. I can tell you that. I know what's happening behind the scenes. I've seen a lot, and it'll be great. And thank you so much for being part of this and to come out. So that's what I have to say today, and thank you so much.
Thank you for everyone who came out. We do have press kits at the back, and the fact that you're here means that you're on our mailing list, but if you wish to interview anyone, we're all going to be here for a while, and I hope that you'll come out to the event at the Hilton. Thanks very much again. So we're all done, but do any of you speak French? I know you do. But good. Anyone else? Yeah, me too.